Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the SKS Airspy SV tire pressure sensor monitors. The rule of thumb for cycling is to always check your tire pressure before you ride. That means either doing a pinch of the tires with your hands or using a more accurate tire pressure gauge or floor pump. The former can be highly inaccurate while the latter can be cumbersome, which is why both of them often get skipped. SKS's solution to that is the Airspy. This is a tire pressure sensor monitor designed for your bicycle to provide you real-time data for your pressure on both the front and rear wheel. You can see packaging-wise, very simple. We have the SV set here. As you can see, it's for the Presta valves. They have an AV version for the same price that has compatibility with Shrader valves. You can see an illustration of the actual module here. You have instructions on the rear in multiple languages. And then additional specs on the side that show you what actually comes in the box. Let's go ahead and open the box and go over the specs. Retail price on this is $144.99. It is a real-time digital pressure sensor module. It is ANT Plus and Bluetooth connectivity, so it'll connect to your SKS app directly to your phone or compatible head units. You get both sensors, the front and rear, and it has a low pressure sensor alert that'll actually beep once it goes under a certain amount. It is IP67 rated, so fully weatherproof. You don't have to worry about it being on your bike in the rain. And it has a 500 hour battery life from a watch battery, a 2032 battery here that's included with it. As far as what's in the box, you get both sensors. Again, both batteries are in there. You just have to pull the little tabs off. You get multiple brackets. They call these the anti-theft brackets, but they really aren't anti-theft. They're more of a support. As you can see, it'll support the weight of this and hold it against the spoke. And you have multiple links to accommodate different wheel sets. You have the instruction manual that helps you get it set up and additional guidance on how to install it right on the side of the box. Now let's take a look at the weight of the tire pressure sensors. There's basically two parts here. You have the bracket and then the main body with the valve inserted. So we've already taken off the little plastic tab. So putting it on here, comes out to 40 grams, so pretty light. Now let's go over the fit and finish of the SKS Airspy. This is a retrofit style design, so you can see it's an all-in-one piece with the battery and all the communication pieces directly into the body. And this will simply slide over your existing valve. You don't need a tubeless setup with a removable valve core. It'll work with a tube bike, non-tube, road bike, mountain bike. So a very clever design that's compatible with almost any bike out there. The downside to this approach is the fact that you have this bulky battery sticking off your valve now. So if you have a thin, lightweight bike, this might be a bit of an eyesore. And it's not much larger than the actual battery itself with this tapered body, but it's definitely something you will see. Now, the nice thing of this design is it simply slides over your existing valve. No additional tools or specific setups required. The only compatibility issue is if you have to have a minimum amount of valve sticking out, which most bikes should, as you want to be able to access the valve anyways. So the body on this has a two-piece design. You have a little lock ring, and you just take it off by hand. Don't use a tool on any of these parts, so you don't want to over-torque anything. Push the valve through, and now you can see you have a metal valve body, and this slides over your Presta valve. Again, they have an AV version for Shrader, so that will work with mountain bikes. Then you have the main body again, so Airspy written on here. Simple black design with the battery underneath the cover. Now let's set up the Airspy on our Priority Ace. Being a commuter bike, this is perfect for the Airspy. You always want to make sure the pressure is correct when you're commuting, but don't want to go through the struggle of always checking it. So first step, deflate all the air from your existing tire and open up the valve. Take off the body from the Airspy and then slide it over and just thread this on. So just hand tighten it, don't use a tool. And you want to keep going until it's already all the way flush, because that'll ensure the air pressure is actually sealed in here so you can inflate it from the Airspy. Once that feels tight, then you want to place the body on. And again, the orientation is such that you want this to be the leading edge and then that to be the trailing edge for better aerodynamics. This being the front wheel, rotates that way. So we want this to be on the bottom side. push it down, and then you can see you can orientate this so that it sits against the spoke. So then you want to place the bracket, call this the anti-theft bracket, but obviously it's just a support bracket. It only goes on one way, you can see it's contoured. So you want to pick the right length for you. The shorter one works best here since we're so close. Then you take the lock ring and then hand tighten that on the top. And if you've done everything correctly, this should be a nice airtight seal in here, and you'll be able to inflate the tire directly from the valve on the SKS Airspy. Now let's take a look at the SKS MyBike app. It's a pretty nice app, so you can do everything from figuring out your tire pressure by picking exactly your weight, your bike, your type of riding. You can look at the Airspy data. So if we go full screen, you can see it'll show me both front and rear, which I've already connected. And if you've deviated, as I've done here by just deflating the rear tire, you can see I've deflated I've had them connected on the wrong way, front and rear. It's kind of confusing to know which is which, but now that you know, you can actually switch it back. So you can see the pressure on each, the battery status on each of them, which is nice, so you know what's going on. And then this will actually show up red on the front because the rear here is actually low, which is actually connected as the front sensor. So pretty nice, you get the cell phone alert notifying you, hey, it's low. You can change the set point too, so if you have a desired pressure that's not 90, you can change that as well. You also have multiple bike profiles. And then with this app, you have this nice cockpit view where you can record a ride. You can look at your speed, duration, and then the little speedometer, just like a car. It even has a little bell, which is pretty cool. The app isn't perfect. You can see sometimes the colors don't show up. And then connecting the sensors takes a little bit of time. So, and it's not obvious which is which. Obviously here I have them flipped, so I would have to disconnect them and reconnect them. And that does take a little bit of time. But otherwise, pretty nice setup and lets you kind of walk up to the bike, make sure the sensors are awake, and then check your pressure before you put the actual pump on there. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the SKS Airspy. What we like about it is that it has simple installation. You can put this on a tubeless road bike, mountain bike, anything. It's just simple retrofit design. It has low pressure alerts too, which helps you catch leaks early, as you can always check your tire pressure. And the MyBike app provides a lot of features which you can use to monitor the pressure or the Garmin Connect software. Some of the cons for the Airspy is the fact that it's a very premium price. It's a lot to pay for just to know your tire pressure, and that retrofit style results in a bulky form factor, so you can actually see the battery on top of your valve. And finally, the Bluetooth connectivity can be a little slow, so you can't really just walk up to the bike. You have to make sure the sensors are awake and they're detected. Taking everything into account would give the Airspy SV an 8.6 out of 10. It's a nice bike-specific tire pressure sensor monitoring. It lets you really track the pressure and monitor it for changes. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.